I'm just going to do a couple of videos on things that most people don't think about, new vapers don't think about. You know, you watch a couple of good videos, you watch your typical RDA building guys on YouTube, you watch Rick Tripper, you watch Grim Green, you know, a couple of other guys, and then you go build, and you go, oh, I better check my resistance. And then you say, I better check my battery, make sure I have a good battery. Okay, but besides that, you don't think about it. So, what's going on? Well, this is a 0.18 build. It's a dual parallel 24 gauge 7 wrap. It's a lot of metal. And I have it on a single 18650. I'm going to tell you, that's about the limit of what I would usually use an 18650 for. This is it. This is the end of range. Could I go lower on the ohms? Yes. Could I have that many wraps of metal and expect? Yes, but what I also am going to do is I'm not going to try and take 7-second hits on this thing. First of all, it'll run dry and give me a dry hit. But the second thing is it's too much strain on the battery. Now, I have Steam Engine up on my laptop. It's also an app for Droids, not for the Mac or iPhone. But I got Steam Engine up, and I'm just unregulated, which this Mech mod is, atomizer resistance. I'm at a 0.18 ohm build because I checked it on an ohm meter, so now I know my resistance. But I want you to understand something. As metal heats up in a wire, the resistance goes down. So if you start out cold and read this, if you take a 1 second hit, do you realize at the end of that hit, your ohms are lower? If you take a 3 second hit, a 5 second hit, a 7 second hit, that's why progressively faster and faster, more and more and more vapor. This is why you have ramp up time. This is why you have, it gets hotter and hotter and hotter until you can't stand it. Now, fortunately, your lungs fill up, your gag reflex, you'll cough. These things, it's your body regulating. But if you're able to withstand the heat and take a longer and longer draw on a low build like that, your resistance is going down and down and down and down. What that's doing is it's allowing more and more and more power faster at an accelerated rate to go out of the battery into your build. And that's why you have to look at other things about a battery, like discharge rate. You know, that 35 amp, this is an eFest 18650, 2500 milliamp hours, just tells me how much charge I have in there. And the discharge rate is set, it says amp limit 35 amps. But this will even tell you, no battery can predict. They can put it on there, but it doesn't guarantee the battery is going to function that way every time, all the time. And over battery life, as this thing gets used, recharged, how many cycles of recharging, its properties will change. All right? They can put what's predictable on there, but they cannot say what's going to happen one hit to the next. So, you know, somebody's vaping habits, if you change and you want to now be a cloud chaser and get bigger and bigger clouds, the answer is not taking longer and longer draws. The answer is build differently. But I just want to read some things on here. There's amp headroom limit, which means, yes, the battery's rated for 35 amps, but not continuously. It can get there and be okay and not vent, but it doesn't want to be at 35 amps. Now, amp is power draw. It's like you turn the faucet on, there's water coming out. Now you turn the faucet all the way and there's faster velocity of water. Well, faster velocity of discharge of energy from a battery into anything is going to create heat in the battery. You ever feel this part of your mod? And you think, wow, that's not from your addy. Your addy's heating up here. The battery is what's heating up the tube. The battery itself is getting hot. So just understand, the hotter that battery gets, sooner or later, decay and failure. So play around with Steam Engine. It's free. You can go on there, look it up on Google, go to the website, and you can play around. This is under battery drain. It's telling me what's going on. Battery capacity, nominal power, estimated total runtime on this build, 7 minutes. So I got 7 minutes of, you know, I'm not obviously vaping it 7 minutes straight, but logically, let's look at it this way. Your first hit is kind of a warm-up. That's why if you watch cloud competitions or you're in them, you have a vent. You know, they give you a 1, 2, 3 count so you could do, right? that's getting the coils ramped up and heated, and it's getting all the uncooked juice out, so then now you're ready to take your real draw for your clout. So but what you should understand is that ramp up time of the coils is heating up, but what happens to the coils as they stay heated for progressively longer and longer, 1 second, 2 second, 3 seconds. Usually most cloud competitions, it's a limit of 5 seconds. Your regulated devices have a cutoff usually, which you can set differently. You know, the Kangar EVOD was 5 seconds. The MVP was 5 seconds. This thing is maybe 7 seconds. The God Mod is 10, and you can adjust that down. It's insane to take a 10-second hit. There's no need for it. I'm at 6 minutes. I'm going to stop this.